Stitchless TV, and I'm Tree, and today you're going to learn so much stuff. Now for the zip. What we do is we've got to put the zip right sides together with our jacket. So remember, there's a scoop on that facing. So we're going to sandwich the zip in between the facing and the actual jacket, and then we just stitch it together. So we're going to sandwich the zip in between the jacket and the facing like that, and we're going to stitch it all in one go. But you know what, it's a good idea to hold it in place with a zigzag first and then go in with a straight stitch. So I'm going to turn my machine to F, which is a large zigzag. Whenever you have anything a bit tricky to sew, I just find it really so much easier to use a zigzag to hold it in place. So that's just the zigzag holding it in place, and I'm going to the end of the jacket. But remember, to leave a bit extra for where you fold up for your elastic to go in. Now I'm going to go in with the straight stitch to hold my zip in place. So I've got my needle to the left so I can be as close to the zip as possible. And when you get to that great big bit where you've got the zip pull, you'll need to lift up your zip, put your foot back down again, and just stitch on the tips of all those V's. Now we do the same on the other side. So remember, we've got to put the zip right sides together with our front, right sides together, lining up the zip with the top, the same as before, and then creating a sandwich with our facing. Put the facing on the right way round, so you've got the top at the top, sandwiching the zip, and we're going to do a zigzag to hold it in place first. So this is what we've got so far. Now, let's undo this zip because our life will be a bit easier. We need to finish off this neck, okay? So you put your zip in like that and you need to bring the facing around. But before we do that, I just want you to overlock, zigzag, hem, bias bind, whatever you want to this edging. I'm going to overlock mine now. So my facings, I overlocked. Now watch this. This is your neck, there is your zip. Turn your ribbing down so that you can fold over your facing, and you're just gonna re-stitch along that line. Carefully stitch over that zip. So I'm using my hand wheel at the side for that. And then I'm just gonna stitch around the curve. But look, there's the facing. Going around that curve. Backwards and forwards at the end, and you'll be very impressed, I'm sure. This is where the top of the zip is. I'm just gonna cut off the excess fabric there, turn this around, and you'll see it's a really nice, neat way to finish off, but you must press this. So I'm giving it a quick press, but that's a nice way to finish off that neck. Now the same on the other side. Now you probably find that your facing is much longer than the actual jacket because it was cut to the original neck shape and then we reshaped it. So when you've got it all nice and flat and you've pressed it, this is your time to trim off the excess on both sides. Now for the final part, the hem. We need to, first of all, fold back this facing. Now be conscious of where that great big bulky metal bit is, because you don't want to sew on it or you'll break your needle. You want to be just beyond it and stitch straight across there. So stay equidistant from the edge. And this basically sets the length of your hem. Now I also need to just cut away some of the bulk from here, but don't come too close to there because then that affects your hem. So I'm going to cut away here. A pair of scissors like that. And I can cut away this top facing bit before turning it around to have a little look at how the hem looks. So you can see the hem taking shape. So I've done both of them. Look, there they are, done both of them. Before I press that hem, I'm gonna overlock the edge, or you can zigzag, or use bias binding. Now, before we even entertain the thought of stitching our hem, we have to press it into the final position. So this is the moment for doing it. Now you'll see you might just catch a little bit of your pocket, but don't worry about that. What is important is that your side seams are lined up. Line up your side seams. So go all the way round, pressing the hem so it's the same width, same length, same width. Go all the way around. So I'm going to line up the side seams here now. We're just going to stitch this hem now all the way around, making sure that we line up our side seams as we sew. So I'm starting just a little bit past that facing. I'm going to go backwards and forwards. I know that my hem is the right width for my elastic. So you need to make sure that you have the right width of elastic for your hem. Now, you might want to trap your pocket into this hem just a little bit if you can. If you can't, don't worry, because you can always do some sort of little tack there. But just go all the way around. I'm stopping just short of that facing. So, finish the hem, but we need to find elastic that fits it. Now, I've got this lovely elastic, and I know it's a bit criminal to put it inside, but I like my elastic to be a bit loose, but it's too wide. So I'm just cutting it down to the first line, and that seems to be the right width for the bottom of my bomber jacket. So I'm going to keep doing that until it's the right length. So I'm going to check out the size of it. So I'm going to put it around where my bomber jacket actually would fall. Now remember, the elastic doesn't go all the way to the front, so put it to where it stops. And for us, it stops at that facing on the jacket near the zip. So when you think it's right, just cut it. Safely put a big safety pin on. And our access point is, we're going to access it because we stitched our hem. Look, we stitched it. We stitched our hem from there. So we should be able to just get in here and start threading the elastic, going all the way around the hem, but be careful to make sure that it doesn't twist as it goes around. So keep an eye on that. Keep track of the end when you're pulling it through. So when the end gets to this point here, you want to stitch that down now. Okay, so what we're going to do is I'm going to stitch up, making sure I capture that facing, stitch up and then come across and then go back down again. So making sure that I'm going to be about a centimetre away from that facing so I definitely catch it. Straight stitch, backwards and forwards, to begin, straight, and then meet up with my stitch line, which I think might be enough, just like that. We've done that and that looks pretty good. So now if we come to the other end where we've got the pin, we've got to carefully, without twisting, pull it out a bit, leave the pin there for now, make sure that nothing has twisted. See how I just stretched it out? And get ready to do the same on this side, but don't stitch over your safety pin. You want it all nice and flat, like that. My safety pin's sort of somewhere over here. And I'm gonna stitch up, coming up, and then coming across to my seam. But it's not flat, so I'm gonna make it all flat. We need to make sure that the gathers are equally gathered, and my sister Shaz, she just loves this. I haven't got a clue why. You stretch it right out, maximum stretch. Let it naturally fall back, and then you will have, in theory, equal gathers. Now, I want us to put a stay stitch on the side seam here, on the side seam, and then on the side seam there, so that our elastic doesn't twist round. Just use a straight stitch. I'm stitching in the well of the seam, which is right in the seam. I'm not going backwards and forwards, it's just a stay stitch. And then do the same on the other side. We are finished, but you know what I'm like about pressing. I just like it when I press the gathers on my elasticated bit. And then, look at that. Is that any good? Nicely finished off, I think, inside. I know you think I'm faking it when I show that I'm so excited, but I'm so excited. I really will be wearing this. I love it. When I started out, I didn't have a clue how it was gonna look, but I really, really love it. Thank you so much for watching Stitchless TV. Now, I love all your comments. Keep all those comments coming. I do reply to all of them eventually. And don't forget to visit my Etsy shop, Stitchless TV. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.